The cannabis industry relies on laboratories to give us accurate reports about the THC and terpene levels in our cannabis and extracts. But what if I were to tell you that these laboratories have been giving us wrong information for years? My name is Drew, owner of MrExtractor.com, and I'm here to give you the truth about cannabis testing in today's video, Cannabis Terpene Profiles and Laboratory Testing, from the Terpene Institute. So all the laboratories are wrong. That's a pretty bold statement, but I'm going to explain it. My name is Drew, owner of MrExtractor.com, and I create cannabis terpene profiles. What I do is I take individual terpenes, I use a lab analysis of cannabis, and then I use those individual terpenes to create a cannabis profile. Now, my terpenes have been in millions of products all around the world for years, and if anybody understands this stuff, it's me. I did a little digging, and I'm going to tell you what I found. So, first off, as a manufacturer, I rely on laboratories in order to tell me what the terpene profiles are of individual cannabis strains. We take our cannabis, good profile, take it down to a lab, they do a terpene analysis, and we use that as a blueprint to recreate the cannabis terpene profile. But how do you know that's right? We all assume that that's because it's a laboratory, they're gonna be right, but how do you really know unless you compare it against something else? So that's what I wanted to do. Now, when you're talking about terpenes, we all take them at face value, but as a manufacturer, I needed to go a step farther. I had some doubts about whether they were actually giving me accurate information or not, so I decided to do a test. What I did was I took one of my terpene profiles, one that I know exactly what I put in it. I took a very simplified profile that only had a few different terpenes in it, I knew exactly what the ratios were, and I took them to three individual laboratories, laboratories that I've been using for years, and I wanted them to test it and tell me what they found. The results were quite interesting, to say the least. Now, I'm going to give you an example. Alpha pinene, for one, is a terpene that we use in some of our products. Now, interestingly enough, in one lab analysis, it came back at 75%, that my ratio was 75% alpha pinene. At another laboratory, it was 26%. We're nowhere near either one of those. So what does that mean? Well, I've talked with a lot of other manufacturers of terpenes in the country. We all happen to talk to each other. It's a pretty interesting situation. And what I've been told by them is that they would take my terpenes to other laboratories, analyze them, and try to recreate my profiles, and they all failed. I found that very interesting for a long time, and it's something that stuck in my mind for a long time as well. So I decided to see what would happen when we took our profiles to a lab and had them analyzed. I was shocked to find out that it did not come back as to what I put in them. So when I looked at it from the other manufacturer's point of view, how would they try to recreate something I do when they get a lab analysis, take it to their lab, recreate it, and it doesn't taste anything like mine? Two problems. For one, their terpenes probably taste different. They're individual terpenes. And for two, there's something wrong with the lab analysis. And sure enough, that's what I found as well. So what I found in these three different lab analysis that I took were the numbers were vastly different in some of the terpenes. Now, some of the terpenes were pretty close all across the board. Some of the terpenes were drastically different from paper to paper to paper. And in some analysis, there were terpenes there that I didn't even use. In some analysis, they were higher. In some analysis, they were lower. What does that mean? Well, if you're trying to do any lab analysis, it means a lot. I'm gonna take a second and tell you some of the things that I've experienced. When I first started this company, I would take our terpenes in for lab analysis, and you know what they came back as? THC. They told me that some of our products were testing out at 30% THC, and I know for a fact that there was no THC in it. We all use these laboratories and we try to trust them and understand that what they're doing is the best that they can in a new industry, but the fact is we heavily rely on them, especially when you're buying a product that may be used for medical benefits. Unfortunately, I have found that across the board, they are not accurate for one and not the same as each other for two. So what does that mean? Well, I'm just going to give you a couple warnings because I can't change the laboratory system. First off, I've had products that tested very differently in THC levels. I've had terpenes that I purchased that tested positive for THC that when I took them to another laboratory, tested negative for THC. I know there's no THC in my products, but what does that say about the products you're testing? I've also had them come back with some very different results in terpene manufacture. Now listen, if you want to make your own terpenes and you're taking a cannabis strain and you're taking it to a laboratory, you have to be aware those levels may not be correct. And even a 2% difference between one terpene and a different terpene and a different terpene, you are not going to be accurately able to reproduce that strain. Now, I've manufactured enough terpenes to go in millions of products, and I've tested thousands and thousands of combinations of terpenes. I can tell you that a small variation in the terpene can throw the entire mix off. What I recommend is that you watch my videos on secrets to blending terpenes and understand how we actually do it here, because getting a laboratory test is only part of it, because I know that those laboratory tests are incorrect. Now, if you don't believe me, take something of yours, go get it tested at 3 different laboratories and see the difference. And while, you know, a little bit of a percentage here or there may not make a difference, when you are creating a terpene profile, I guarantee that 1 to 2% of a very strong terpene is the difference between your product tasting like crap and your product tasting like an amazing cannabis strain. Thank you for watching. Do your own research and go to theterpeneinstitute.com and check out all of our other educational videos. We are here to help you make money and help you help those who need help. Take it easy. I'll see you soon.